smell nice. I guess I won't see you for a while.
Come and visit.
Yeah, I will, I promise.
I want to hear you play again.
Without a piano, Tricky.
Then bring one with you.
We'll all miss you guys.
It's been a long time coming. Place is full up.
Don't forget to call us soon as you arrive.
Yeah. A second city. We'll make it greater than you can ever imagine.
Them's fighting words. This it?
Yes. The Liberator's base of operations. All the city survivors we find, we keep safe here.
What? Never seen a field?
No. Those guys, they're Kavesi and Agnian soldiers, aren't they?
They were. Teacher and the others freed them.
Doesn't look like they died in combat. All the husks around here are whipped thin.
You think they starved?
Maybe.
With this much wildlife around, though?
Most things around these parts are poisonous. Not really edible.
Well, there's castle supplies. Don't they get those?
You think they got raided, maybe?
Doubt it. Enemies would have mopped them up. No sign of blade wounds. For whatever reason, intentional or not, these people were abandoned.
Local fauna aside, with this much fresh water, they could have easily farmed. There's so many ways they could have kept themselves alive.
Thing is, though, fighting's all these guys know.
Yeah, but...
You know, they're not like us. Nobody taught them what could be.
It's not as simple as plant some seeds, wait for the harvest. We're teaching them the ins and outs, as you can see. We're showing them there's more to life than battle.
You didn't do this in the city?
No. We did do that stuff. We did, but...
This world of peace where nobody has to die. Make it come true.
What's this? Oh, a couple of armories.
Armories? You mean those Levnus looking things?
Yeah, they're the city's mobile assault vehicles.
They're fitted with a pretty nifty cloaking device.
We got our hands on these particular bad boys after some Mobius lackeys shot them down.
Sadly, the impact of the crash caused significant damage to several systems.
Seriously? Is that why they're still in pieces?
Can't you fix them?
We've been trying, but they've been giving us some trouble.
Right. So you haven't seen Niel?
I'm really sorry, Matthew. It was hard enough for the six of us to escape. But hey, it wasn't just our group. I heard Naomi's group made it out as well. There's a chance she's with them.
Naomi?
It seems Caleb tried to stop them, but they weren't able to hear him. We think they were headed towards Fornis. Except he said he was too far away to see who was actually with her.
Right.
This is Niel, though. Bet she's with him, A-okay. She's like you, mate. Hard as nails and twice as tough.
Uh-huh.
You've got it so much easier, you know. At least yours is well-behaved.
You're jealous? That's a surprise.
That's not what I mean.
Nothing about this is easy. There's this awkward distance between us. I'm just lucky that things panned out this way.
Is that right?
It's all about how to handle things in the moment. That's the crux of it. Or at least I think so. You were independent from a young age, right?
Yeah, well, apart from Gramp sticking to me like glue. But I supported myself.
That explains it then. The way you think of her. As being somehow different from you. The paths you've walked are too unfamiliar. No? Try talking to her again. But be yourself. Actually... Perhaps she'll be the one who comes to you.
Hey, Shulk and Rex! The search party's returned!
Huh? You've not found a single person.
There were clear signs of combat, that's it. But, as I've informed you, we've not been able to confirm any survivors. There were no husks present either, so I'd expect it to have been monsters.
But even then, can't see the whole group croaking it. Nagai's unit should have been the cream of the crop.
Any case, we brought back anything we could find on the scene. Most objects belong to the unit, but there were also a few oddities.
Namely?
According to Charon, things that may have potentially belonged to city refugees.
Oh.
Oh. I know this! Oi! Where'd you find this? This belonged to Niel. Tell me!
Like I said, the location of the SOS.
Is that true? You better not be lying.
Matthew.
It is, I'm not. It was with everything else on the ground by a tree.
Oh no. Niel.
What is this place? Looks older than Colony 9 by far.
To be honest with you, it's a super ancient ruin. And when I say super, I mean ultra mega ancient.
Yeah? Buildings made of stone. That's pretty primitive, all right.
Hey now, it's primitive buildings like these that are still standing today. Admittedly, there's not as much left standing as when I saw it the last time. But still, you can feel the magnificent weight of history, right?
Huh. suppose.
Wow, tough crowd. I guess it figures.
No traces of Ouroboros power being used. Plenty of footprints, though. Although, they seem to all be from search party boots.
Nothing else at all. Gotta be some trace of the refugees.
Oh, there's something all right. But it's weird.
Weird how?
There are tracks leading up to here, but nothing to suggest that anyone left.
So, do we think they were done in? Oh, sorry.
To strip their corpses. We'll be eating fine this week. Why are we bringing those people with us?
Drop it, Nael.
Matthew!
You know why, surely?
Yeah, but...
Some of our folk were soldiers. Spare a thought for them, yeah?
Makes no sense.
Nael.
Haven't we done enough? We could have just kept to ourselves, but we're still doing this. And now Kyra's dead.
Nael, you here? Why in the dark?
Go away. With or without Mobius, nothing will change. In the end, people always kill people.
Those soldiers were still part of the cycle. I bet they were controlled.
Doubt it. No red irises. Savages. They killed Kyra just to add on a measly few extra days.
Come on. That's worst case.
Matthew, Always in fantasy land.
What?
You can't keep every bloody person happy. How can you not understand it's impossible?
The only true end is the moment you give up. Isn't that what Grandad taught us?
Then show me already! This world of peace where nobody has to die. Make it come true. You think you could do that, do you? You think you've got what it takes?
I...
Well, I don't. I'm barely holding on. You hear me?
We can't yet be sure that she's dead. Even the footprints. The search party's little skirmish could be wholly unrelated to this.
In my head, I get it, yeah. Except, in my heart of hearts, I bloody hate this.
You hate what?
These stupid bodies we have. If only we turned into husks, the same way that soldiers do. But no, we vanished without a trace. No evidence, nothing.
I understand your unease, but keep heart.
I know. You fellas, can I help you?
Food's up. Saved you some. Come on. Everyone's having a blast.
I'm not depressed or anything.
Oh, I know you're not. That's not what I was implying.
We're having a little shindig. Matthew, I don't suppose you'd mind telling us about your sister, what happened to Niall and so on. I wouldn't want to force you.
No, it's fine. All right. It happened on the day the city fell. Mobius.
Niall! Grandad!
Matthew.
Grandad!
Take care of Niall, the future.
Grandad!
It's in your hands. Matthew.
When I came to, I was all cuts and bruises.
Back then, A was the one that nursed me back to life. Found me while traveling, apparently by pure chance.
I see. That's why.
It's not just that. It's him too. The Mobius bastard. I'll wring his neck with my bare hands. I swear it.
You've hardly changed, to my eyes.
You're saying I'm like him. No need to throw it in my face.
So why do you look like that?
Logos was the male persona, and Numa the female one. Ontos was meant to stand somewhere between, forming the Trinity Processor. It all adds up to me.
I see. Does Matthew know? So about you and Alpha, what happened? How did you split apart?
It was unforeseen. For that Mobius and man to have that kind of power. To my fortune, it unshackled me from the chains of Ontos.
Chains?
As you may know, And this is surely evident to you, Shulk. But Origin, it's based upon the architecture of Ontos's core.
I heard about that from Melia. A gift from Alvis, she called it.
Ontos was the Arbiter. And thus, was predicated on the existence, or perhaps the opinions, of the others, Logos and Numa.
In short, without the two of them present, Ontos was just a machine.
My original, he was shaped by Klaus, and shouldered the man's regret as he was born into that world. Hence, he was able to help you. But he is no longer. The me that is left is just a machine. And machines know no sympathy. That's why he took steps to erase this world. To create a new future in its place. Debris of the past. And the noise that permeates the present. Your lives are to him redundant. His conclusion that only new life, that of the people of the city, ought to be preserved. Ontos proclaimed himself Alpha and chose to leave for a new world, shepherding the citizens along with him, while erasing the old world in his wake.
However, Ben's intrusion caused something of a setback.
That is not all it did. In any case, I was able to separate from Alpha. The memories of traveling with you, and all other faint recollections, they compose me. You could call me his conscience.
So, here's what this conscience or whatever is saying, then. There's no life that deserves to be left behind. All life is worth saving, more or less.
Yes, that's the gist of it. I suspect that if Logos or Numa were here now, they would surely say the same thing.
Yeah, I bet. So why tag along with the kid?
You've good reason, don't you?
For Alpha to command some form of power in this world, he needs a body to inhabit. Yes. Like how Zamza once lived in you, and Matthew's sister.
What's this? This wind? Over by the lake?
I've come to fetch you, Matthew. Come. It's time to go.